Hello, you're with the Auntie Mummy, and happy Valentine's Day to you. We have these lovely little cards that I created a couple of days ago now. I've had a pretty interesting few days and haven't had a chance to get this up for you guys, so just in time. Unfortunately, my 3-year-old got hold of this one and I'll have to put a new backing, a new card onto it and remount it. Because he had a bit of fun with that, with the watercolour pencils and a paintbrush. But I'm pretty happy with these. In the end, I ended up putting some black fine liner pen around the hearts just to define the edges a bit and tidy it up. And I'm pretty happy with how they turned out. And my gorgeous little girls had a go at painting some for themselves while I was cooking dinner last night, and they really, really enjoyed having a go at theirs too. So there's another one that I did. It didn't turn out so wonderful, but the one on the right there is by Aaliyah. She's 5 years old. I think she's done a stellar job. She's my little little creative. And the next one is by Kiara. She's 8 years old, and she's pointed out to me that this is not quite finished, but I think she's doing a beautiful job of that one too. So congratulations to my gorgeous little girls. They've done beautiful work there. Now today's tutorial is going to be quite long, and kept it as I painted it, just slow and relaxing and easy to follow. And I do hope you enjoy relaxing and painting along with me to create some beautiful hearts. Please enjoy. Hello, you're with the Artie Mummy, and today we are going to make a Valentine's Day card. So I'm going to be using watercolour. And all I've done is, so far, is grabbed a bit of paper from one of the kids' unused school books and put some hearts on it with my little watercolour pencil, cut them out, half hearts I should say, I've cut them out and we're going to use these bits here, and all I have is some alizarin crimson. I've got that in Winsor & Newton. Some French ultramarine. And maybe, I'm not sure if I'll be using the gouache. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is divide my paper. So I'm just going to use very light marks. So that should be halfway, and then I'm just going to use the width of my ruler, and we're going to take a piece. See how I go for time, we might even make two cards. Okay, so we're going to use this space inside of here. I don't know if you can see those marks I've made, but they will become obvious as we go. So I'll have a border area, and what I'll end up doing is getting another sheet and cutting this section out and popping it on top so that it's got a nice white frame and a bit of dimension to the card. Make it look a little bit more plush and lovely. So now I'm just going to take my hearts and I'm going to just kind of randomly pop some hearts on here. In the negative. Just tracing around the outside edge of that, so we end up with some nice, lovely
heart shapes on the page. I need to fuss too much with it. Oops. The reason I'm using a watercolor pencil is because I really don't want any pencil marks to be showing on my paper when I'm finished. And I don't have to worry too much about being terribly accurate because it'll just disappear into the painting. Make sure to get nicely around those edges. Put a couple little ones on here as well. You can be really random about these or purposeful in your arrangement. It's entirely up to you how you want to do these. So I've just gone with three different sizes. You might want to do two or four or whatever takes your fancy. Okay, so I think that'll do nicely to start with. Could have gone with a little bit more shape in that one. Just fix that up a bit. Okay. So now we're just going to take a little bit. Now we want it to be very, very light to begin with. So not very much pigment. And we're going to pick out a couple of these hearts. Make sure to dissolve that watercolour pencil. Just going to fill it in. Nice and light. this here so you can see. So not too much pigment at all. I think I want this to be one of the main ones. We're working wet on dry here. Feeling a little bit of texture in there. And one more, maybe this one right here. Love that traffic. Now I'm going to allow that to dry. So on this other side, let's try for something a little bit different. Do the same again, but I'm just going to use the small heart, I think. Just want that to be a little bit more shapely.
it's just going to take too long for the video for me to do them all. This will just show that it doesn't matter how you do your hearts, this should work out quite nicely anyway. Okay, let's pop these ones in. So I've got a bit too much of a puddle there. It's going to take a little bit too long to dry. There we go. Can't go wrong with little hearts. So just two colours of paint, ultramarine blue and alizarin crimson. But you can use any two colours you want. A rose or an acre would probably be quite pretty. I love aquamarine. Pinks, purples. So just going over the pencil marks, just enough to dissolve them. I'm not using so much water that we're going to have to wait forever for it to dry. I'm making sure to start really nice and light and pale, because the next steps are going to depend on that being nice and pale. So what we're going to do is we're going to get darker as we go by having more pigment and adding ultramarine. Sorry, French ultramarine. In that mix. Don't really want any hard lines on this. Not at this stage anyway. Pulling out a tiny bit of that pigment at a time, so I keep this lovely soft colour. Just work those pencil lines until they dissolve.
this technique isn't necessarily only for watercolor. You could use pencil, you could use acrylic, you could use anything you like. As long as you start soft, like this, and then you'll see as we go that we work back to make this something really striking and pretty. Soften that line anywhere that I've got any hard lines happening. Just want to soften them out while it's still damp, because it's much harder to fix that when the paint's dry. Odd, isn't he? That's a little better. Okay. Now we're going to do our next layer of hearts. And you can see these guys aren't perfect, so don't worry yourself about it. I'm going to be bringing just a little bit more pigment in. And do the next layer. Really important to make sure that the layer before is dry, because otherwise they're going to bleed. And with this particular style, we really don't want that happening. Go slightly over the edge of our line. That's where we're going to cut it, and we don't really want to have to either cut into our size that we've designated, and we don't really want to have to put up with any white lines around the edge. Too, we can drop a little bit more pigment in there. dinner. Now let's draw some more in. So all the hearts from now on are going to be not in front of these guys necessarily. Time to put these ones in. So I'm just going to mix up a bit more of this paint this time. Sorry if you can't see that very well. There we go. Okay, we want to just go outside that border just a little bit. And you could tape a border and have it as a single layered card. And I like the idea of having more than one layer. Come on, you. Isn't that a lovely rich red? You can adjust the shape of your hearts just a little bit if you need to. The pencil lines really are just a guide. Don't stress if you make a little mistake. It's not going to be the end of the world. This does take a little bit more patience than some of the other techniques I've seen for making watercolor Valentine cards. Some of them are just beautiful that people are doing. I've seen a couple of them getting around and I thought, I haven't seen anybody do this way that I thought of. So I thought I'd just show everybody what I was thinking of. Oops, see a little mistake there, so I'm just going to correct that in. Uh oh, there's a baby awake. One more. I'm going to have to get a seat at that. Sick. So he just wanted a bottle. If you're wondering what the music in the background is, I often do too. It's my children's electric piano playing by itself. And I find a little bit of classical music to be really relaxing. I like to have it on when I paint. And I really hope I'm not breaking any copyright rules by doing that. There we have it. Okay, that one done. Now we're going to bring in just a little bit of the French ultramarine into our alizarin red. Sorry, alizarin crimson. I'm so bad at remembering the names of paints. We should get another tone from that. Let's have a little tester. Okay, so we're getting slightly into the sort of more purpley colour now. Just a little bit. So with each layer we're going to go just a little bit darker. Careful not to go over of the previous hearts. So carefully go around them. Just let that colour fill in. Without getting too much moisture on. Because like I said, I do want to have my layers dry fairly quickly because we need to go wet on dry. I'm really not good at getting that nice and even just yet, am I? So, still need to work on my watercolour technique. And a little bit of blue in that again. So just being really careful not to upset those previous hearts. A little bit more pigment in there. And then we're going to go back over to this one. Some more. Going to start really filling in some of these gaps. Excuse me. There you go, so carefully with the paintbrush, and then I go over one of the light hearts with the pencil. I think I'm really careful now with just a clean brush. Oh, I can just blend that out. No, I'm done.
just about do.
Mix up some more of my darker purpley red. Let's check that we've got the right colour going on. Yep. Maybe a little bit darker. So we want to get a nice contrast between what we've already got down and what the following layer is. I might go back to that little one. And some of them are going to seem oddly shaped because they're behind others. This isn't the most relaxing piece it's ever played for me. Never mind. Kind of exciting. Just going on with my brush. I think I need to stop letting kids use them. To the point that I'm hardly able to find a decent one. Let's try and get that tip back a little bit. Cute little ones. Especially when you've got a brush that doesn't want to make a point like you want it to. I've accidentally left my other good brushes, their other property. So we have a little farm. Until recently we were living there all the time, but we've had to bring it back to weekends pretty much because of work commitments and things. This weekend I meant to do a bunch of painting, and I actually did a bunch of sleeping. I definitely needed it. A little bit of R&R. This is called negative painting, I think. Please correct me if I'm wrong. Find little pieces like this to be very cathartic, beautiful and relaxing. You don't have to think too much, you just, I say paint, don't think. And it'll all turn out in the end, because that's when you let your intuition take over. It'll just happen. Here's my baby girl. Okay, so here's where we're up to. So I've already got this little one in here. We'll have one more. Yeah. One more down here. We'll just balance that darker tone with just a hint. Oh, Tyler. Little man waking up. Okay, so we're almost there. So larger hearts are definitely easier. It's a bit irritating. That's okay, don't worry about it. So we've added just a little bit more of the French ultramarine to make more of a dusty colour. Bit of a darker tone. Oh, I've got a tickle in my throat tonight. We've gone to quite a violet, haven't we? Come off around there. Definitely need to get a little bit more water here. Get that colour a bit more even. So even though this red is quite dark, because it's just a heavily pigmented version of the alizarin crimson, it's going to still be quite different tonally and different hue, different colour. And the one with the French ultramarine in it, which is another step back in the colours. Okay, now this brush is really annoying me. So for our final little layer, I'm gonna grab this little one. Now we're just gonna add a little bit of that alizarin crimson to the French ultramarine. We're going to go the other way around. Let's see what we get. I want it even more blue than that. My goodness, I don't have a decent brush right now. I should be right back. I'm going to try and fix this brush. Okay, so you all saw how this brush of mine was misbehaving. This one also, but I'll stick with this one. Hopefully it'll behave itself now. So if you're like me and you allow your small people to use your good brushes and they often forget to take them out of the water or even to clean them, you can reshape them and bring them back to good as new most of the time with a little boiling water. Just dip it in there, hold for about 5 to 10 seconds, and bring it out and shape it, and it should cool into the shape that you want it to be, and it will be perfectly good to use after that. we hope. Okay, lucky last. Okay, now because everything's pretty dry, I think a little bit of interest going in this background. Varying the amount of French ultramarine and Zoan crimson we've got going. What we're really aiming for is a really high contrast between the hearts and the background. How beautifully they stand out now. You can even take this one step further and define another layer of hearts within the blue by cutting out with, say, a black or a very dark blue, purple. Putting that area of paper there, get some more heavily pigmented paint and drop it in there so you get a nice dark shadowy look back there. This is where you can correct any mistakes that you might have made or that you feel you might have made on the way. And we're just painting the negative space. Okay. I think with this one, just add in another little heart or two here and there.
dry enough yet.
Alright, so we're going to grab our little layer of red, and we're just going to pop some shadows on here and there. Here, get a bit more dimension. Okay, so the point of this is to show you the difference it can make to add shadow and add drama by getting some really dark contrast and negative spacing. Whether that negative space is white space or dark space. Contrast and strong shadows can make all the difference to how your finished piece works, how it looks. And I think I'm going to leave that one at that. I'll probably keep fiddling with it all night. Now this one. What shall we do with you? Oh gosh, I hope you could see all that. Shall we do the negative space? I think we will. Thank you. These brushes really are dreadful. Wasn't the best idea to use this one, but I don't have very good control with either of them, so six of one, half a dozen the other. If you can hear those guys fighting outside, the flying foxes, bane of my life at the moment, because they like to pew on my car. I can't get rid of the tree that's over my parking space because tree belongs to my neighbour. So patience is a virtue. Getting a tad impatient with these brushes, but unfortunately, can't be helped right now. So I'm just going to have to persevere. Hide a couple of my brushes from the little people. Notice I'm sort of going more into the blue as I get down. Just thought I'd try that for something a little bit different. says as she picks up some purple again. So, far from a masterpiece, but hopefully my little darlings will like them and they will give them to their little friends at school maybe. What do you want, my sweet pea? Why can't you sleep, sweetheart?
I'm sleeping this time, but Mama, I couldn't sleep the other time.
Yeah, can you get back to bed, my darling? Don't forget to close the door. So it came to tell me that she was having trouble sleeping the other night, but not tonight. Begs the question, what are you doing up at 365 days of art, I believe, is going to be a bit of a failure on my part. It was an ambitious thing to start with. But me being all inexperienced with YouTube, thought, oh, no problem. Each one of these exercises will only take me about 15 minutes or so. I can do that. So there's a couple of things I didn't account for. And one is that editing and uploading and that sort of thing. On average, for a 15 minute video, because I'm not very experienced and not very good at it. And that was actually supposed to be the point, is to, by doing daily uploads, forcing myself to do daily uploads, that I would get better at it much more quickly, because you have to. Practice makes perfect. And yes, I have improved dramatically compared to when I was uploading really randomly once every week or week and a half or 3 days or whenever I happened to have enough time. So I did get much quicker over the last month. And that worked really well in that respect. But because it is taking up so much of my time, getting that daily upload to happen, and really failing at the moment anyway, because while I am doing art daily and getting my practice in that area, I have found I've kind of hit burnout a little bit. And like I said, I had planned on doing art and catch up on Sunday, and ended up resting and sleeping because I really, really needed to. And self-care is something that I have to do, because if I don't look after myself, I can't look after my family. And that's the number one priority to me above anything else. So, Lorna Scobie's art book, which by the way I have left at our property this week, so that kind of, I take that as a bit of a sign from the universe saying, this is not going to happen, just face it. Which is really challenging for me because I don't do failure very well. Has been pointed out to me before that if I'm nothing else, I'm determined. If I decide I'm going to do something, then hell or high water, I will do it. But in this case, I'm going to concede defeat. But what that will allow me to do is when I need to work on my books. So I have a what are you doing up, Isaac? I swear they play tag team. Okay, Isaac's 13 now and he's quite capable of getting himself a drink and putting himself back to bed. Okay, so there's one very messy heart. Let's get a little bit more of this dark purple in here. So I have a little bit of a contract happening with a local author, and I need to finish illustrating the book I'm working on by mid-March, which isn't a problem. Quite able to do that if I'm not spending 4 hours a day on a little art book that really isn't gaining me anything very much at the moment. I feel like I'm probably actually annoying a lot of my subscribers. And I've noticed that a few have dropped off lately. Whether that's because they were following me because of the book. And because I fell behind on that, they've gone elsewhere. Or because they follow me because of my acrylic and pastel tutorials. And I've been annoying them with watercolour and 365 days of art. So, I don't know. That is really awful. I like this one. This one is really, really awful. So I'm going to be focusing more on what I need to be doing to further my career as an artist and keep you guys happy with some actual tutorials. And hopefully that'll work better for everybody. So I'm going to cut these out now. If you're going to do this, definitely go with the simpler, larger heart. idea, because these would have been much too difficult to put all the shadows and dimension on, and this is just a lot more striking and a lot more effective. This was much too difficult to get the transition sort of from the blue to the mauve, but to the dark purple colour, to go relatively evenly. This one's not great either, but I think it's much more successful than this one. So let's see. Piece of watercolor paper. Cutting's a little bit off. I'll throw that one away. I think what I'm going to do is brush. going to let that blend out to nothing. Just drop in a little bit of colour. Let that be pretty. Bit of a hard edge there. I don't really want. when that dries, so I can stick it down. Move my scissors and things. Lifting that off there so that it comes back to almost white. Okay. Well, tell me what you think, and if you did a Valentine's card or not. I'd love to hear from you and know what you're up to, and I will catch up with you soon. One little teensy weensy thing. Mr. Shadow. Okay, there we have it. So here's how they turned out. In the end, I took a black fine point pen to them, and I'm really quite happy with how this one came out, except that you'll see you got a smudge on the card and a bit of wrinkling on the back and drawing because my 3-year-old son got hold of it this afternoon. But we can easily mount it on another card, that's no problem at all. So like I said, I'm pretty happy with how that came out in the end. And not unhappy with this one either, now that I put some definition on it with the black pen. Got all those hearts to come out and have a bit more evenness to them. And some others that we played with, that one's pretty ordinary, but look at these beauties. My little girls wanted to have a turn, so Aaliyah, that's hers. She's 5. And Kiara, who's 8, made this one. And they did those unsupervised with my watercolour pencils while I was cooking dinner tonight. So, clever girls. I think they've done a stellar job on their own without any help. And yeah, if you enjoy my video today, please like and subscribe, leave me a comment, let me know what you think, and happy Valentine's Day to you.